Hey everyone, welcome to my channel Dental Edge. I am Dr. Bhanachar. I'm an MDS in oral pathology and today I'll be sharing with you a very commonly asked question, that is a lichen planus. So I have divided this video into two parts. This is the part 2, which includes the clinical features and oral manifestations of lichen planus. Do check the part 1 and part 3 as well for complete lecture. Now let's see the clinical features. Coming to the clinical features of lichen planus. Lichen planus, it is more common in females than males, right? The ratio is 1.4:1. Then usually middle age, more than 40 years, although it can occur in very young or very old, but usually middle age, more than 40 years is the common age. Then let's first see the skin lesions. How are the skin lesions of lichen planus, right? So skin lesions, they are classically purple, pruritic. Pruritic means they cause itching. So they are purple, pruritic, polygonal, right? They have many sides, angled sides, and there are papules. Now, to understand these terms, papule, macule, plaque, all these terms are basic terms that will come again and again in the skin chapter. So for this, I have already uploaded a lecture on common terms for the chapter skin. You can check that video. I'll mention the link above on the screen. So it is purple, pruritic, polygonal papules. So they can be small, angular, flat topped. I told you lichen planus is flat topped papules, right? That are only a few mm in diameter. If you can appreciate here, these are the papules. A papule is a solid raised lesion of less than 1 centimeter. So there are papules that are only a few mm in diameter. They are small, angular, flat topped. These papules, they can be single, that is they can be discrete, or they may come together and coalesce to form a plaque. Now again, you should know what is a plaque. A plaque is a solid raised lesion of more than 1 centimeter. You can check that lecture for common terms, right? So papules, they may be discrete, that is they may be far, or gradually coalesce into larger plaques. They may form plaques, right? And each of these, they are surrounded by a very important point. They are surrounded by a fine glistening scale, and the papules are sharply demarcated from the surrounding skin, right? Now, early in the course of the disease, these papules or plaques, they are reddish, right, followed by purple or violaceous hue. So early in the course of the disease, the lesions appear red, but they soon take on a reddish purple or violaceous hue. Later, a dirty brown color develops. And one of the most important point is that these papule or plaque, they are covered by fine grayish white lines, which are called as Wickham's striae. This is a very commonly asked question. Where do you see Wickham's striae? The answer is lichen planus, right? So its surface, these papules, the lesion surface is covered by very fine glistening scales, which are called as, they are white or grayish in color, and they are called as Wickham's striae, right? If you can see this, these are the papules. If we see the zoomed image, there'll be fine glistening lines. If you see this image, if you can appreciate, these are the Wickham's striae. This is the lesion with Wickham's striae. This is a closer view of the lesion, and there are fine network of lines which are called as Wickham's striae present on the papules, right? Then how will we remember this? To make it a little easier, for skin lesions, remember PPPPW, P4W, 4 P's and 1 W. Just if you remember this, that is also more than enough. What is that? Polygonal, right? Many sides are there. Papules, right? Solid raised lesion of less than 1 centimeter. Purple in color, right? And they are pruritic. I already told you, pruritic means they itch a lot. There's lots of itching, is a very common sign, skin lesions ke liye. So polygonal, papules, purple, pruritic, these are my 4 P's for skin lesion. And Wickham's striae, fine glistening grayish white lines are covering these papules, which are called as Wickham's striae. Okay, so these are papules, right? polygonal in shape, purple in color, pruritic, they itch, right? And if we see a closer view, there are Wickham stripe, right? Now let's see what is the site for skin lesions, right? So the skin lesions, they may occur anywhere, but remember that they are usually bilaterally symmetrical, right? So the lesions may occur anywhere on the skin surface, but they are usually distributed bilaterally on both the sides, right? Symmetrically patterned. And what are the common sites? Flexor surface of the wrist and the forearm, right? So flexor surface of the wrist and the forearm, inner aspect of knees and thighs, trunk, especially the sacral area, face is usually not involved. So the face frequently remains uninvolved, and in long cases, chronic cases, you will see hypertrophic plaques, long-standing plaques may develop, especially where on the shin, that is the area front of the leg below the knees. So you can see hypertrophic plaques in long-standing cases, right? So in chronic cases, hypertrophic plaques may develop, especially on the shins, that is the lower aspect of the front of the leg below the knee, right? What is the primary symptom for skin lesions? There is pruritus, that is there is lots of itching. So primary symptom of lichen planus is severe pruritus that may be intolerable, right? In patients with oral lichen planus, scalp involvement is not very common, but what you can be asked, scalp involvement by lichen planus is also called as, you should know this term, lichen planopilaris. So lichen planopilaris means involvement of the scalp by lichen planus. It is not very common with oral lesions, and nail involvement is also very rare. Just remember this term, lichen planopilaris is involvement of the scalp by the lichen planus. So these were the skin lesions. So we have seen the clinical features, in which age it is common, what is the sex predilection, then what is the common appearance on the skin. Now let's see how it appears in the oral cavity. So what are the oral manifestations? So the majority of patients with skin lesions, not all, right? It is not compulsory that it will occur both in oral cavity and skin. Maybe it's either or both are involved, right? So the majority of patients with skin lesions, lichen planus, have associated oral lesions of the disease, right? So there are many forms in which lichen planus occur in the oral cavity. The most common and the classic form is called as reticular form. So this is the classic form of lichen planus, the most commonly seen form. What will occur in this? Lesions consisting of radiating, right, white or gray velvety thread like papules. So there are papules, right? How are these papules? They are radiating, and grayish white velvety papules are there, thread like. So lesions consisting of radiating white or gray velvety thread like papules. In what pattern? It can be linear, that is they can be in a row, straight or nearly straight line. Annular means ring like pattern. So papules in ring like pattern can be there. Or retiform arrangement. Retiform means a net like pattern, right? So forming typical lacy reticular patches, rings and streaks over the buccal mucosa. So one of the most common site for oral reticular type is buccal mucosa, and remember bilaterally on both the sides. So on the buccal mucosa and to a lesser extent on the lips, tongue and the palate. So the reticular form, it will show papules in a linear ring, that is annular or reticular, retiform pattern, net like pattern, right? Then on the buccal mucosa, so these are the sides. Again, we will see white lines, grayish white lines, which were called as Wickham stripe on the skin lesions as well. So in this case also, in reticular form, we will see white lines. So there are white lines known here also as the stripe of Wickham, that is Wickham stripe are seen as well. Let me show you one image so that this becomes a little clear for you. If you can appreciate, this is a reticular form. Again, in this image, we can appreciate interlacing white lines, Wickham stripe are there, And papules are also there in a net-like pattern, right? There's a net-like pattern on the buccal mucosa. This is the most common type of oral manifestation, the reticular form. Sometimes there can be, in addition to papule, plaque as well, right? So when plaque-like lesion occur, radiating striae, that is Wickham striae, may often be seen on their periphery. If you can appreciate a larger lesion, a plaque-like lesion with radiating striae on the periphery, this reticular form, it is usually asymptomatic. There is no symptom. So usually it is asymptomatic. Sometimes slight discomfort can be there, right? So this was the reticular type. What is the next type? The next type is the bullous form. Now this bullous form, as the name suggests, there will be vesicle and bullae. Now you should know what are vesicle and bullae. For this, check out the lecture on common terms used in skin diseases. So vesicle and bullae are seen in the bullous form. It is not a common form. It is not a common finding. It is difficult to diagnose. So vesicle and bullae formation is there, but it is not a common finding and it is difficult to diagnose. These bullae and vesicle, they may rupture to leave behind a erosive surface, right? Which you may confuse that it is an erosive form of lichen planus, which is the next type that we will see. So next is erosive form. It is also seen next to reticular form, the erosive form is seen. So in this erosive form, there are erosions or ulcerations. Erosion is incomplete loss of epithelium. Ulceration is complete loss of the epithelium, right? So there can be erosions or ulceration, right? So it begins as such and not as a progression of the bullous form. That is, bullae have broken and given rise to erosion or ulceration. It will itself start as erosion or ulceration. So it begins as such and not as a progressive process from non-erosive lichen planus. What will we see? We will see ulcer. Eroded areas. So eroded or frankly ulcerated lesions are seen that are irregular in size and shape and appear as raw painful area. This type is symptomatic. Patient will have pain in this type. So there will be raw eroded painful ulcers. Now how will we identify it? Usually again you will see Wickham striae. So characteristic radiating striae may often be noted on the periphery of the lesions and this may help in diagnosis. So diagnosis possible if typical radiating striae are present at the periphery of the ulcer. This is the erosive or the ulcerative form. This can also be seen sometimes. So this is a ulcer in the center and Wickham striae or radiating striae at the periphery of the lesion. This is on the buccal mucosa. Then next is the atrophic form. So atrophic form, it is erythematous, reddish in color it will be. Erythematous, mucosal atrophy and red patches will be there. It appears clinically as smooth, red, poorly defined areas, often but not always having a peripheral Wickham striae. So Wickham striae may or may not be present and this is also symptomatic. Patient will have pain in this type. This was the atrophic form. Next, one term you should remember is desquamative gingivitis. Right? Desquamative gingivitis. What is desquamative gingivitis? Red, diffuse, painful condition of the gingiva. If you can appreciate in this image, red, painful, diffuse condition of gingiva is called as desquamative gingivitis. Initially, it was thought that it is a separate entity, but it is not a separate entity. It is seen in many dermatologic diseases with oral manifestations. So even lichen planus, the erosive or the ulcerative or the atrophic lichen planus, when it occurs on the gingiva, it will be called as a desquamative gingivitis. So it is now generally accepted that this is not an entity, it's not a separate disease, but represents a variety of conditions. including the oral manifestation of several skin diseases, one of which is lichen planus. So, a type of lichen planus occurring on the gingiva. Which type? Either erosive, ulcerative one or the atrophic one. So, usually the atrophic or the erosive form that is occurring on the gingiva is called a desquamative gingivitis. Then, next is hypertrophic form. In this well-circumscribed, elevated, white lesion resembling leukoplakia. So, sometimes there will be a white lesion resembling leukoplakia. In such cases, biopsy will be done for diagnosis. So, these were the types: reticular, erosive or ulcerative, bullous, atrophic, then hypertrophic. Now, these oral manifestations, they may occur weeks or months before the appearance of the skin lesions. Many patients with oral lichen planus may never manifest the skin form of the disease. Other mucous membrane along with oral mucous membrane can also be involved. These are the mucous membrane of the penis, vagina and the epiglottis. The genitals are involved in as many as 25% cases of women with oral lichen planus, compared with only 2-4% of men with oral lichen planus. So, involvement of the other mucosa, mucous membranes, may occur along with oral mucous membrane or without involvement of oral mucous membrane. So, we are done with the part 2, that is clinical features and oral manifestations of lichen planus. Next lecture will be part 3. Also, notes for the lichen planus are available on my website. The link for the same I'll mention below in the description box. Then I also take regular online oral pathology classes. If you want to join the same, you can WhatsApp me on the number mentioned on the screen. You can also join my WhatsApp group. The number for the same is mentioned on the screen. It takes lots of effort to make such videos. Your one like can give me lots of appreciation. So do like the video, subscribe to my channel and keep watching. Thank you.